reveals. And not only does the word of God reveal, but the word of God keeps me in anticipation. It says that God has promised to do some things for me. That's exciting, y'all. So now what I'm doing in my life, I don't know about y'all, but you get a whole lot of stuff in your life. And I think this is a good practice. And you got to watch what's in your life. Because, you see, if it get only what comes from God, is going to last. Are y'all hearing me? Tell your neighbor that only what comes from God is going to last. So now, this is mine. And I think that this is something that God gave me, I think. I don't know. But I need to see whether it was made in Japan or whether it was made in heaven. Because only what is from God will last. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. If it don't have promise wrote on it, then it won't last. You need to look at who you're sleeping with. Look across their forehead and see if you see the word promise. If it don't say promise, it's gonna be a problem. Y'all don't hear me? Because turn it over, catch it on its way in the shower, make sure it's got a big promise. Coffee, if it's not a promise, tell your neighbor it's gonna be a. Whining and dining, smoking and joking. Let's just cut straight to the chase. If it ain't God's promise, oh, if it's not the promise of God, it's gonna be a problem. So now, you see, your past is like a gateway to new beginnings. Somebody say, I got his word. Now, what does God's word have to do with my past? God had a providential plan all along. But now I'm like Saul. They turned to Paul, the scales are slowly coming off my eyes. Somebody say, I can see clearly. I can see clearly now. Oh, that the rain is. So now my past was a gateway to new beginnings. Ooh. Let me just think about my past. God, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Supposed to do that in crusades. Thank you, Jesus. My past is the bridge that brought me over. And now when I hear them old folks talking about their stories, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use their stories. I'm going to be creative, and I'm going to make their stories an intricate part of my own life. In other words, let me say it this way. God, if you were good for mother, truly, truly, you are good enough for me. If you were good enough for my daddy, surely, surely you're good for me. Come on and give God a praise. So spiritually, here it is. You know, I think that God wants us to reflect on the past so we can go ahead and get our breakthrough. Let me tell you what I'm talking about. He wants you to smell the cornbread cooking on Sunday evening. Ham is done. Potato salad ready. I smell the cornbread. He wants you to hear the raw crown sizzling on the front eye with the straining comb on a Saturday night. That blue or the green burger mount stripping down the neckline. Ouch, mama. You done blown my neck. God wants you to remember those mornings that you told that little white lie about how sick you were and couldn't go to school. By the time mama got to work, you were up running, flying like a June bug in the summertime. He wants you to remember that candy at Uncle Elmer's store, the corner market, when he said, go ahead and get your own candy. You gave him 2 cents for 3 pieces, but you took 5. He wants you to remember going through the checkout at Walmart, and mama told you to put it back. Soon as she wouldn't look at you, put it in your pocket. He wants you to remember sitting in the back seat of that old car, all four of y'all had to sit in that car, and you would sit in the middle taking up all the room so your sisters and brothers couldn't sit down. Holler and say, mama, they squishing me back here. Oh yes. God wants you to remember when you tried to roll the window down and you had a pair of vice grips locked on. Yeah. Oh yeah. Remember when the only way the window come up, somebody had to get on the outside, somebody on the inside, and scoots the window up. Now it's your neighbor and say, build on it. Don't forget the first time you drink, trying to be grown. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I thought I was gonna die. Yeah. Running into walls that wasn't even there. Stumbling over bricks that didn't even exist. Tell your neighbor, build on.